Amen. Thank you. Please be seated. As I said, we were dealing with this, the book of 2 Thessalonians, and in 2 Thessalonians, it touches on this same topic. In fact, we kind of went back here a little and dealt with a couple of verses here, and then back to our text passage there in 2 Thessalonians, where the Word of God does deal with this all-important topic. You see, I think that the message today that needs to be sounded and pounded into our ears and our hearts today is the message of the fact that Jesus Christ is coming back. Amen. He is coming back. Yes. And we're supposed to live like He's coming back. Hallelujah. We're supposed to live like we're going to be accountable and give an account to Him when He returns. Right. If we will remember that, I think it would help our Christian walk a whole lot more. Amen. If we would live as though we're going to be, we must be accountable to those, to the Lord when He returns. I think if we thought about that, it would help us. So they asked a good question. They said, Lord, we understand You're going to come back. They didn't doubt that. But they said, they asked Him the question, how are we going to know? He says, what shall be the sign of Thy coming and the end of the world? You know, people want to know that today. Yeah. What's it going to be like in the end of the world? And there's so much speculation. You know, there's some that say, well, there's not going to be any end. There's no end to the world. It has been here for, and they say this, billions and billions and billions of years, and it'll be here for billions and billion more. They don't have any science to prove that. But they say that, and today, for some reason, probably because we're so intelligent, we believe it. Because the scientists said that. And somebody who has studied said that. But if you ask them, what is the proof that the earth has been here for billions and billions and billions of years? They will let you know clearly, well, it is a theory.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, there is a theory of evolution, not the fact.
Right.
I like facts.
Yeah.
But there's a theory of evolution. Look it up. You know what it's called? The theory of evolution.
That's right.
When you can't prove something and you don't want to be caught in it, then say, well, we can't demonstrate this because it takes billions and billions and billions of years. And of course, no one can do that. They've got a built-in excuse. How did evolution take place? Well, it took place and this is what happened. Prove it. Let's see it. Demonstrate it. Oh, we can't because it takes billions and billions and billions. Folks, let me tell you something. The Lord's coming back.
Yes.
And I don't think, now I can't say, the Bible says we don't know in the book of, in the first chapter of Acts, it says not only do we not know, but it's not for us to know.
That's right.
All right? But I just personally don't think that it's going to take billions and billions and billions of years now for the Lord to come back.
That's right.
Well, why do you say that? Well, He tells us that there are some signs that we can look for.
Yeah.
Now, first of all, I want us to look with me at verse 4, where we see that there's going to be a global deception. Global deception is going to take place. Our message this morning is worldwide signs. Worldwide signs. He said they're going to be signs. They're going to be worldwide signs. Look at verse 4. Jesus answered and said unto them,